When I look back over my life and I see all the things God's done for me, been through danger, heartache, and trouble, I thank the Lord, He's rescued me. I could have been dead and gone, then the Lord, He spared my life. Oh, yes, He did. Now I can say that I'm still here by the grace of God. When I look back over my life and I see all the things the Lord has brought me through, been through sickness, trials, and suffering, I thank the Lord, He's blessed me still. I could have lost the faith, and I could have fell from His grace. Now I can say that I'm still here, and it's by the grace of God.
Good morning, guys. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. Yeah, so that song is by the grace of God. I want to first welcome all of you to Tuesday Talks with Tanika. Thank you guys so much for taking a small portion of your Tuesday morning to share it with me this morning. Today is Tuesday Talks with Tanika. That song is really, really ministered to me this morning, and I hope that the words of it can minister to you today. That we are still here by the grace of God. We are still here by the grace of God. Real quick before we get started, if you can go ahead and hashtag Tuesday Talks with Tanika. Go ahead and hashtag Tuesday Talks with Tanika. Share this video on your page, on your wall. Tag your friends, your loved ones, your family members, those of you that you know you will come in contact with. Go ahead and share this video with them real quick. We won't be before you long today. Had a little bit of a technical difficulties this morning, but I am still here because of the grace of God. So I just wanted to go ahead and dive in real quick and get started. As I stated earlier, we're gonna just elaborate on His grace. We're gonna elaborate on His grace, and I know just like me, a lot of you have gone through situations in life and situations that should have taken you out, situations that should have killed you. That car accident that you were in, you shouldn't have survived it. That state of depression that you were in, it should have landed you into a mental institution. That abusive relationship that you were in should have landed you in the hospital. My God, but because of the grace of God, we're still here. We're still here because of His grace. We ever wonder why everything that we went through had a logical and justifiable reason to take us out. A good reason, if you look at the way it looks on the outward, you should not be here today. If you look at the how the odds were against you, if you just look at a little, go back a little bit in your life and you realize the things that you've gone through, the things that you don't even look like that you've been through, those things should have taken you under. They should have swept you under. But because God is so graceful, because He's so graceful, because He loves us so much, because there is purpose for our existence in this world, we are still here. And because we're still here, we have victory. Because we have victory, we can share our victory with our brothers and our sisters. We can share our stories. We can share our testimonies. We can share what we've gone through with those that are coming behind us because we have victory through His grace. Some of us has been in some bad situations. Some of you may know some people or may have experienced drug addictions, that should have taken you out. That last dose, that last needle that you put into your body, that last overdose of that last pill should have taken you out. You shouldn't be here today. But because of God's grace, because of God's grace, we're still here and we're still here to live to towards us. It's nothing that we've done so great to deserve this grace. It's nothing that we've done that's so upright and so standard, but because of His love toward us, He's extended that grace to us to say, you know what? Although it looks like you shouldn't be here, although it feels like you still shouldn't be here right now, although they say you shouldn't be here, although it would make sense for you not to be here right now, but because of my grace, and although you have requested to get out of a situation sometimes prematurely, you have requested to say, God, you know what? I can't deal with this anymore. You have prayed to God and said, you know what, God, if you can just lighten up the load a little bit right now, you've said, okay, God, I want to back up from this right now. I've learned my lesson, so to speak. But God's saying, in the midst of what you're going through, my grace is sufficient for you. That thing that you want to get rid of, that thing you want to get out of, no. You don't have to get out of it right now because my grace is going to carry you through. That car accident that you were in, where your car flipped over two and three times, and in the middle of the flipping, you're praying to God, if you could just get it right, if you could just get this car back on the road, But God is saying, my grace is sufficient for you, even in the middle of that instant second. My grace is sufficient for you in your situation, and because my grace is sufficient, I'm going to make sure that you get through it. I'm going to make sure you get through this situation. And then when you come out, you won't even have the residue of the thing that you've gone through. People won't even be able to look at you and say, oh, you've been through XYZ. You've gone through this. Oh, you had a rough life. Oh, you're suffering from this. They won't be able to look at you and see what you've gone through because His grace has allowed you to look perfect to the eye of the person that needs to witness this testimony. And sometimes people won't even know that what we've gone through in life. They won't know the magnitude of what we've gone through until we tell it. And that's the great thing and the great nature about God, because until we open our mouth and tell what we've gone through, you'll have no clue of how low and how much of the valley experience that I've gone through. because God's grace will allow it to be visible to your eye. But he will allow my mouth to speak that which he has taken me through, so that when you see what I've gone through, you will know that if God can take her through this, if God's grace can be sufficient, even though she had that thorn in her flesh, even though she wanted to give up, even though she couldn't see her way out, even though she was on the brink of battling the depression, even though she was on the brink of committing suicide, even though she was on the brink of killing somebody else, even though she was on the brink of taking that drug overdose, God's grace was sufficient. Even though she was in that abusive relationship, even though she was in that mental breakdown, even though she was in a financial crisis, God's grace is sufficient. His grace was sufficient for you to go through, so that when you come out, you can show others that because of God's grace, I can smile today. I can smile today. I can have joy on the inside of me because God took care of me in my situation. Even though I was locked up, even though there are situations that I should have been locked up for, God's grace. Even though when I went to court, God's grace. Even though I should have been fired from my job, God's grace. Even though I should have been written up, even though I should have failed that exam, I should have failed that test, God's grace. God's grace was sufficient for every situation that you have found yourself into, whether it be a situation that you've imposed upon yourself or a situation that you fell into. God's grace was sufficient for you, and God's grace is specific for you. Somebody else's grace might not be the same measure of your grace. I tell you, some people need a little more grace than others. But we just thank God today for his grace. His grace is so sufficient for us. His grace is measurable to our situation. It equates, it balances on what we're going through. His grace allows us to be able to go through things with ease, to go through things knowing that God is going to get me. I can be confident in the God that I serve. I can be confident in the things that I'm doing because God's grace is going to continue to cover me. God's grace is going to continue to take me through. If I just hold on, I'm still here. I'm still here because it's grace. His grace allowed me to be here. His grace allowed me to go through that thing 10 years ago and to tell about it today. And if I told you what I went through 10 years ago, you wouldn't believe me. Because God's grace has been so sufficient for us. So I pray today that you guys will look back over your life, look back over the things that God's grace has brought you through, that if it wasn't for the grace of God, that we would not be here today. But because we're here, we know that God's grace brought us through. And because we're here, we're not going to keep our mouth closed about what we've gone through. We're not going to keep our mouth on mute about what we've experienced. Because of his grace, we can share it with our brothers and our sisters. We can share it with those we come in contact with. We can share it with those we love. We can share it with those that we don't love. We can share it with those that we don't like because of God's grace. I bless God today for this message. I thank you guys so much for watching today. I thank you guys so much for watching. And I pray that you will share this video with everyone that you know. Share this video on your page because someone needs to be reminded about the grace of God that has been covering them, that has been taking them through their situation. That if it had not been for God, that they would not be able to open their mouth to utter even just one word. And I just want to thank you guys for watching. And I pray that today is a blessed day for all of you. Join me next week on Tuesday Talks with Tanika. I love you all. Have a great day. Bye-bye.